Hi everybody, my name is Bahush, speaking to you for Fotodiox, and in this video, we're going to go over our favorite five facts about the all-new Visilex ND Throttle. It's a lens adapter with a variable ND filter built right into it. All right, fact number one. Now this has some actual science in it, so I hope you're sitting down. Variable NDs are great, except they don't work really well at wider focal lengths. Like on my Canon lens here, down at the bottom end, we've got 24 millimeter, 35 millimeter. You'll actually see a pronounced visual effect where the ND just isn't working right. I'll show you in fact. Let's put a regular adapter on this Sony camera, like so, and let's put this variable ND filter on. Screw it to the front of the lens like you normally do. Okay. Now if I fire up the camera and let's just aim at the white background behind me. I'm just gonna take a picture.
Do you see the shadow in the upper left and the lower right? That's what the variable ND does on a wide lens. We also mounted a variable ND on the Canon 18-55mm kit lens, and that shaded cross is even worse. But that's just how it is with variable ND on the front of a wide lens.
If we zoom in a little bit, you zoom right into the center of that shaded area and take a picture, and you're fine. So again, when you zoom in, you're gonna be okay, but if you wanna use your lens, you know, kinda wide, you're just always gonna run into a problem with a variable ND on the front. That's why the ND Throttle puts the variable ND in the adapter itself. So no matter how wide you're shooting your lens, you'll never see that effect. So now that I've got the Visilex ND Throttle on, the ND is behind the lens. So you're not gonna run into that strange kind of cross-shaded effect. In fact, I'll set the lens to its widest. And again, just shoot the white background. There you go, no problem. Number two, if you're working on a shoot with multiple lenses and you're going to be swapping between them, you don't want to have to bring along a whole pile of ND filters in all different sizes to fit all those different lenses. Well, with the ND Throttle, it's all built right in, and it's just easy to switch a lens out, fly a new one on, and you're ready to go just as soon as you mount the lens right onto the adapter. Another kind of side benefit is that, you know, you've got ND glass in there, so it protects your sensor a little bit while you're switching your lenses around. But mainly, it's all about being ready to go just as soon as you put that lens on. Number three, the ND Throttle takes you from ND2 up to ND10 and every value in between. So no more trial and error going through a pile of ND filters trying to find exactly the right one for your shot. You just dial in however much you want. Number four, the ND Throttle lets you shoot at lower f-stops even in bright shooting conditions. And that means you can get those shallow depth of field effects for dramatic, cinematic effects in your video or in your photos. And number five, if you're shooting stills, you can do dramatic long exposures even in bright sunlight just by dialing up the variable ND. So you can get these beautiful artistic blurred effects no matter what the shooting conditions are like. Right now you can get this Visilex ND Throttle that connects any Sony E-mount NEX type camera to a Canon EOS lens and gives you versatile variable ND right inside the adapter. If you just click the link down below this video, it'll take you right to the order page and you can have this in your hot little hands right now. But we've been reading in the comments from our prior videos that you folks have other things in mind for the ND Throttle. So which ND Throttle would you like to see next? Would you like to see one on your Canon camera or your Micro Four Thirds camera? Do you want to see support for Nikon lenses? Just let us know down below and you can help us decide which ND Throttle Visilex should make next. My name is Bahush, thanks for watching.